All right, friends, we are here for our ELA practice where we are practicing our learning target of I can determine the meaning of unknown and multiple meaning words and phrases in text. So we know that we can use context clues to help us determine the meaning of an unknown word. This is important so that way as we're reading, we make sure that we're fully comprehending the information that it's giving us. So to do that, we're going to practice with a passage that's linked in Canvas. It is about the American Revolutionary War and some causes leading up to it. So go ahead and pause and make this graphic organizer on a piece of paper. Make sure that you have all of this down. And then once you've copied this down onto a piece of paper, go ahead and hit play and come back to us. Make sure you have it written down. All right, so now that you're back and you've written this down, we are going to try to find the inferred definitions. Remember, inferred means based on the information that I have and the information that a passage is telling me, I can make a decision. I can make an educated guess. So we're going to try to make an educated guess about the definition of these five words: protest, port, trials, quarters, and intolerable. And together right now, we're going to go ahead and do port. All right, so we're going to pretend that I am reading my passage. I'm reading. And as I get to paragraph 3, I notice that there is the word port. All right, so I know that it's in paragraph 3. So that's the paragraph that I would put down. Let me go ahead and see what clues or what context clues I can find. Over the next few months, Parliament approved a new series of new laws. The Boston Port Act declared that Boston Harbor would remain closed until the colonists paid for the tea that had been destroyed. No ships were allowed to enter or leave without British permission. All right, so as I'm reading, I notice that the British Port Act is about something to do with Boston Harbor. And I also notice that it has to do with ships. Okay, so those are two very important context clues for me. I can infer from this that the port must be where ships enter and go in a city. And I know this because a harbor is where ships come in, and then it's talking about ships as well. So since all of that is about the same thing, that must be what it means. So then when we return to our graphic organizer, you can see that I've reflected that as well. Where did I find the word port? In paragraph 3. Context clues, harbor and ships, inferred definition where ships come in to dock. So go ahead and make sure that you have this one down. And then for your practice, you're going to go ahead and read the rest of the article and find these other four words. Please make sure that you have completely filled out this graphic organizer before moving on to review or apply, because you'll have to have it filled out in order to be successful with that further learning.